So in the previous example, we have seen how to create a check button. Now we will be seeing the values inside the variable. So actually these variables contain the values when we press, when we tick mark the check button or not. So it contains only two values, either 0 or 1. So if you press check the checkbox, it will contain 1. If you leave it blank, it will contain 0. Let us see that. So for that, let us write a simple code. Let us print the values first. Let us say var1 dot get the value, comma, same thing, var2 dot get the value. These are the default values we are getting first. var3 dot get. So these are not shown in the window. This will be shown in the Python shell. var4 dot get. So now let us execute this. Okay. See here, all contains 0 because we haven't checked this one as a default. So now if we press this one, actually now this value contains 1. So to retrieve this value, let us create one more button and get these values after checking this. So let me close it and let me remove this and create a button now. Button, let us say A, and let us say get values and comma, let us command is equal to mget. Let us place this also on a grid. Row is equal to 4, comma, stick to west, capital W, don't forget. Now let us write this method. Let us define this method. Define mget, and now get the values. Let us write one more button for quitting. Text is equal to, let us write quit, and a dot quit. We can write, we have seen like destroy, this time we will see quit. Both are same, don't worry. And grid row is equal to 5, comma, stick is equal to stick to the west. Now let us try to run it. You can either press F5 or go like this also. Both are same. Non-keyboard ARG. Somewhere we have done a mistake. So I think let us say destroy. Non-keyboard ARG. What is that? So actually, I think we should have to write command is equal to, both are same. Let us see quit method. Now go to the run or press F5. Everything should be fine. So see here, get values, quit. And first let us get the values. See here, all are zeros. Now check this second button and now click on the get values. See here, this one is 1. So these values contain 0 or 1. 0 for unselected, 1 for selected. Let us now select all of them. And click on the get values. See, all are 1. Based on these values, whether it is 0 or not, you can write your own code and place it in the methods using the command. And now if you quit, so actually it is quitting. So when we are pressing quit, it is quitting from the program, not from, it is not closing the window. So if you want to quit, you should have to use destroy. It will destroy the complete window. So when quit is used, I will be explaining it in our further example. For now, if you want to close the window, use destroy. If you want to quit the program, you should have to quit, use the quit. And let us make some more, like width is equal to, let us say 25. Here also let us say width is equal to 25. Now let us execute. So now we got this one, and first get the values, check 2. Hope you understood the concept. So depending upon these values, you can write your own code. Now if you press control, it destroy the window, not only just quitting. So before we used to get this, but the window is still open so that we can run it again. So according to your requirement, you can use quit or destroy. Hope you understood this. Meet you in the next video. Until then, keep practicing.